is the ribbon cutting for TC Satellite Campus. We are so excited. This is a turn in education for Alexandria. It is getting full flexibility to a number of students that need a non-traditional campus to succeed in getting their diplomas. So we're excited about this, and we're looking forward to what this is going to mean for so many students in ACPS.
It is non-traditional. And all of our students will be taking classes online, and they will take their core classes online. And this is actually a 21st century strategy. And we personalize instruction, we also individualize instruction, and the youngsters work at their own rate. And already in 1 month, we've had one young lady who has completed the course. As a matter of fact, as soon as the ceremony is over today, she's going to take her final exam for that course.
This is really the next step when we talk about our satellite campus. It is the next step in education for us here in Alexandria City Public Schools, but also we're making a mark within the state as well as this region. We are the first fully comprehensive satellite campus, which is giving students the opportunity to get their education in a hybrid learning environment, meaning the core curriculum is online, with teachers that are here, certified teachers, to help to support those students when they need them and how they need them. It is really the ultimate in a flipped classroom because it is learner-directed, and you will hear from some of those learners in a moment. A year ago, I was charged by the superintendent to bring forth a plan to address the school board's priorities of decreasing dropout rates, of increasing graduation, and dealing with issues of disproportionality. And what emerged out of that process was really an incredible vision of flexible campus that eliminated almost all of the obstacles that students stated to us got in the way of graduation. So many came together, and I'm not going to name all of those, but clearly within the ACPS team, members of the IT team, including Mary Picardi and Dr. Elizabeth Hooper and Mariah Runkle, and Dr. Lawrence Jointer, as well as Drs. Margie Walsh and the mayor and the city council, so many people came together to say, this looks like something that could help us in that course. And so we're excited. We have 98 students enrolled in the Texas campus. Some of those students have already completed a course for this year that would have taken them into June to complete. They are working at their pace, and they are excited about what's happening for them. So I just want to thank everyone within the division and outside within this community for rallying around this and supporting the students. Thank you for being here, and thank you for being a part of this great moment in Alexandria's history. With that, we have one of our students, who is Stephanie Tullis, and Stephanie actually has performed before the president several times, so we're excited to have her. Stephanie is gonna do a rendition of the national anthem.
Teach me well, I teach myself better. So being able to go online and teach myself something is a lot easier than being in a classroom and some teacher saying, do this, do that. It's a lot easier when there's a lot less stress and they're not breathing down your neck about homework, classwork, tests, and all this other stuff. And when you come here, you just pace yourself. And like, I'm able to do that a lot better than a teacher just looking at me and saying, do this.
out on this rainy day to witness an important event. But let me just mention that as the mayor of the city of Alexandria, I'm honored and a proud titan at that to be asked to participate in the ribbon cutting ceremony here for this TC Wavis Satellite Campus. When the school division began to research the feasibility of providing additional support for our high school students to keep them engaged and ensure that they meet the requirements to earn a high school diploma, the administration did a great job and a great deal of research to find the right approach to meet the needs of these students. Ironically, just about a year and a half ago, I had just come back from attending a Mayor's Conference of Mayors meeting and had witnessed a presentation on a new academic initiative to keep high school students in school, but more importantly, to have an alternative form of education so they can meet their needs instead of the day-to-day grind, the normal curriculum. And so when I came back and started talking to staff about it, school staff, and they said, well, hold on, Mr. Mayor, because we have something that we want to share with you. And lo and behold, it was this very concept. And so I'm very pleased and proud of the fact that it wasn't something that I had to convince them to do. As a matter of fact, when they said they wanted to do it, it was easy to convince me that I needed to convince both my colleagues on city council and city staff to support it and to fund it. So when a proposal came forward for a new satellite campus, it was a great idea that needed a foundation. And that foundation was the location and the school division turned to the city for assistance. The city was eager to support the school division in doing all that was necessary to find a suitable location to build its foundation for this pioneering program. It is through our partnership that we strive to provide continued support and enrichment to the families of this great city. It is a marvelous occasion today as we embark on this journey with these students, the inaugural class of the TC Satellite Campus. Each one of these students has shown dedication to their education by enrolling in this new program, and they have shown faith in us that they will succeed. And just as I paused for a moment, I actually had dinner with a former TC Williams student yesterday who graduated a few years ago. He recently married, and he said, you know, we had a block party in my neighborhood the other day, and he said, people were talking. He said, there are a bunch of kids everywhere. And he said, talk to me about the public school system. And I said, well, what do you want to know? He said, well, people are concerned. And I said, well, what are they concerned about? And he said, well, you know. I said, well, no, I don't know. And he said, well, you know. I said, well, is your wife pregnant? He said, no. He said, but my neighbors are concerned about where their kids are going to go to school. And I said, that shouldn't be a concern. It should be an easy decision. Put them in an ACPS. And so I paused and said, he said, well, people hear that this is going. I said, well, you know what? People have to stop hearing. What you really do is that you go and find out for yourself. You know, you ask, you go, you find out. And you talk to other parents and families, and they will be convinced that it is the right decision not only to stay in Alexandria, but to enroll your kids in our public school system. And so I said to him, he said, well, what about TC? I said, TC Williams is doing just great. As a matter of fact, tomorrow we'll be opening a satellite campus. And he said, wow, that's exciting. And so, you know, just because we do have our challenges, there are opportunities for us to get above those challenges and do better and greater things. And so I'm delighted that you've taken time from your busy morning to join the students here today and to show your faith in each of them and support their success. And again, as the mayor, I'm honored to participate in today's ribbon cutting ceremony to support our students, the campus, and this initiative. I look forward to celebrating the initial success of the program and to the pathways it will light and doors that will open for our students. And just in closing, you know, as a matter of fact, we're having this conversation today about the redevelopment of this particular mall. And when you talk to people about the mall, and I said, and as a matter of fact, I have a meeting this afternoon with the owners of the mall because they're rolling out a new concept. And when they were in before, I didn't. You know, I was a little concerned about something they said they were going to have that they're not going to have now, and I'm going to tell you about it. So, at any rate, when I've been talking to some citizens about it, their initial reaction was, well, maybe they're right not to have that because it will just attract kids to hang out in the mall. And I said, well, you know what, there's nothing wrong with kids hanging out in the mall, particularly now when they can get an education. So, you know what, that's a good thing. Thank you very much.
board members enter after the first introduction, so I'd like to take this opportunity to call them out. Ronnie Campbell is here, our Vice Chairman Helen Morris, our former Chairman Yvonne Folkerts, Blanche Benes, and have I missed anyone? Great, round of applause for my colleagues. It's an honor to serve with them. And I see a lot of familiar faces here, a lot of people who participated with our strategic planning a few years ago. And whenever I need to think about what I want to speak about, I always go back to our strategic plan, because it's really the foundation of where we want to go. So indulge me as I read a couple passages. Our vision is to set the international standard for excellence, where all students achieve their potential and actively contribute to our local and global communities. Our mission is to provide the environment, resources, and commitment to ensure that each and every student succeeds academically, emotionally, physically, and socially. I think that this satellite campus is an ideal example of our objective, which is to create alternative education strategies and programs that will minimize out-of-school suspensions and improve the graduation rate, where we ensure every child is challenged and engaged with school experiences responsive to each student's talents and interests. We're really talking about individualized, self-paced, and accessible education. We want to foster collaboration and shared community responsibility for student development and achievement with all members of the school community. The satellite campus really puts students in control of their destiny, and I hope it serves as a true empowerment, of course, with our support, for them to achieve our goals, their goals. Students need our support to be successful. Sometimes they need a listener, sometimes they need an advisor, sometimes they need a quiet place to study, and sometimes they need a new option. I am proud of this board, this administration, and the city for supporting our students with this new option. TC Satellite Campus offers our students a new approach to learning that they did not have previously. While the traditional high school environment works well for many students, we know that it does not work for all students. We are thrilled to offer this unique opportunity to our students, and we are dedicated to ensure that they successfully complete the requirements to earn a high school diploma. I hope that they have everything that they need to be successful, and I empower them to let the school board know if they need anything else. Good luck, students.
Good morning, everybody. Rashad Young came in. Where's Rashad? He's our city manager. And student touch. Is that what you're talking about? And I should have touched it. And Rashad's also a proud parent of a child at Tucker Elementary School. How many of you have kids at ACPS? Or have? No, yes, Suzanne, you have 3,000 high schools. Well, let me pick up on our chairman's comments and the mayor's comments and share some statistics with you. Because I think the message has to go out from the parents and the community about the remarkable work going on in our schools every day by great teachers and great leaders and remarkable support staff. I sent out a note last week to our school board and to the mayor and others saying that the AP results last year at T.C. Williams High School were the highest in the history, even when you were on the board, Mr. Mayor, of T.C. Williams. In fact, since 2005, the number of students taking AP courses has more than doubled. And you would think, oh my gosh, all these kids are taking tests. You would think that the results would go down as we're ordering down. Everybody's taking AP courses. Well, the reality is that participation is an all-time high, and the results are at an all-time high for AP tests. And we thank you, Mrs. Maxey, for your remarkable leadership at TC Williams. Oh, and by the way, SAT participation last year was at a 9-year high, and results went up last year compared to the year before. Another sign that we are on the right track, and you should be spreading what the mayor asks us to say to your neighbors and all the community, that great work and very good results are taking place. But we also know there is a reality. We know that even though results are up, we know that culture has shifted. Discipline results are nearly non-existent at T.C. Williams. We know that not every student learns in that wonderful setting that we call T.C. Williams. Cheryl Gorsuch has spoke about that. We know that on the strategic plan established by this Board of Education 3.5 years ago, that there was an imperative, a call for changing the way we do our business so that we create alternative settings for our students. That is an alternative setting, is it not? I get to sit here in a mall, and I get to hear the music piping through that everybody else is hearing. I get to get hungry when you mention lunch, Dr. Hansen. But isn't this what it's all about? It's about other settings. It's about working with students to meet their needs as human beings, as individuals, in a personalized environment in this 21st century. And that is the key to this. It is not just another setting. It is not just another school. It is different. It's intended to be different, to create independent, participating thinkers. Are you guys thinkers and learners and independent? Perhaps as they've never been before. And so we aspire here to create a different environment and a different model. And as I've told my staff a number of times, this school, this setting must succeed. Because I don't know unless the mayor's going to shake his head in a different way this morning, or Mr. Young is going to be able to build into a budget another $100 million for a new facility. But in addition to our statistics, we have 13,167 students in seats at ACPS as we stand here, the highest in well over 2 decades. And so where are we going to put all those students as they get older, as they grow through the grades? And the answer is in alternative settings, in satellite settings. So a final thought. You know, I sleep late every morning, so I got up about my usual late time, about 3:30 this morning. And I was looking at the word satellite, because if you remember, maybe you and I were talking, is it a satellite? And I'm not sure whether Cheryl or Yvonne or somebody, when we first started putting together the brochure, and we're trying to look for the right image, you know, going off into space, is it a rocket ship, what is a satellite? So you know the definition of a satellite? The moon's a satellite, is it not? This school is a satellite. It's tethered, as the moon is tethered back to the Earth through gravity, so is this setting, this satellite tethered back to that remarkable organization called T.C. Williams. But just as the moon and just as satellites that go around the Earth have their own independence, their own personality, so does this school. And so we are proud to welcome all of you to the ribbon cutting with the thought that we must do work differently for today's 21st century learners. And this is the model for education for us and ACPS for the future. I'm so pleased that you're here. Thank many, many of you who were part of this dream and making it come true. Most important, I'm gonna thank our students, our 98 students who were busy at work in there while we're out here. They took a chance. They took a chance on us. And they said, I wanna come back to school, I wanna learn, I trust that this setting is something different and better. And we're so delighted that they chose us. Welcome and thank you for being here.
Thank you to Mayor Yule and Chairman Gorsuch and Dr. Sherman. Mayor Yule talked about this new space, this non-traditional space here in the mall. The interesting thing about it is mixed use. But what we found in this, as we knew in that vision, not only are these students here learning, they're also customers in this mall, and they're also workers. We have at least 5 of these students that actually are employed by merchants here in the mall. And so we also want to thank that partnership that we have here in the mall. There are a couple people that I just want them to quickly share their vision. One that was one of my early partners in this mission, and that was talking about the tethering back to TC, and that was Mr. Gregory Forbes, and Greg is the Director of Secondary Counseling. And this really emanated out of the counseling team, because counselors were engaged with the students and their families in identifying if this was a good learning opportunity for them. So I'd like for Greg to share a few thoughts about that early time.
Thanks. Hold it. Hi, good morning, everyone. It's a thrill to be here. I'm very excited that this day has finally come. When Dr. Hinson came to me a few months ago and shared her vision for a satellite campus, I was thrilled because over the years I have met with countless students that the traditional day program at TC Williams did not fit their needs for a whole host of reasons. And so over the summer I met with the first 50 or so students that we selected and referred to the satellite campus, and it really does run the gamut in terms of why our students are here at the satellite campus. We have students that are here because they are on track to graduate and want to graduate early. They know for sure what they want to do with their lives, and really going through a four-year program at TC is not the best fit for them. I met with two students yesterday who are looking to complete 2 years of courses with this first year, and over the course of this year, because one wants to go into the Army and the other one wants to go into the Marines. And so those are students who know for sure what they want to do and they want to graduate early. Then we have students who have been retained in previous years. Maybe they were retained in elementary school and middle school, and they're looking to accelerate their learning so that they can graduate with their peers in the class that they were supposed to. And the satellite campus gives them the flexibility to be able to do that. For some of our students, they work full-time. They work full-time during the day. And so having a satellite campus where students can come in at 4 o'clock in the afternoon and stay till 8 o'clock, or even come in on the weekends to take their classes, it works for them because they work full-time during the day. We also have some students at TC who work in our city's restaurants, and they're often working late till midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning. And so getting up really early to come to school at TC has been a struggle for them. And so now they're able to sleep in a little bit, get here around 10 o'clock and take their courses and stay here until it's time to go to work again. So as you can see, there's a whole host of reasons why students have been coming to TC. Some students learn best by being in a smaller, individualized environment. At TC, students are rolled in 7 classes throughout the day, and sometimes that can be overwhelming for some of our students. And so being able to come here so they can take 2 classes at a time or 3 classes at a time and focus on those classes and then enroll in the next 2 or 3 is a better fit for some of our students. So we are very excited about the satellite campus. The admin team and I have been talking for months about how excited we are to have some of our students here, because I truly believe that we are now serving all of our students. TC, the King Street campus, for the overwhelming majority of our kids, that is the right fit for them. But we do know that we have a number of students based on a wide number of extenuating circumstances are better served in a campus like this. So we're very excited. We're looking at, certainly this will be a success, and maybe even expanding some sites for students so that we can better meet the needs of our students in the future as well. So thank you very much.
With K-12, which is our online partner for learning. Over the past 5 years, it's an interesting evolution of what has happened with our online learning. 5 years ago, there was a handful of students that were taking online classes here in Alexandria. As you know, we have a one-to-one pairing for our students. Our high school students, actually, we give them a laptop to do their learning, because we look at and take very seriously that question about equity and ensuring that we provide those resources to help them meet that need. But as you look at the actual curriculum around it, we also took a lot of time to look at who was the right partner for that. Now, going from 5 years ago, a handful of students that are taking online classes, today we have over 1,000 course enrollments across the TC main campus, our middle schools, and here at the satellite. And so let's give a round of applause for our IT team that has worked hard with K-12. Online learning is invaluable, as Mr. Forbes talked about it, helping students make some decisions about getting back on track, of finding ways of extending their learning or accelerating their learning. And so in helping us meet our goals here in ACPS and our transformation goals within our high school environment, we're excited that we're partnering with them. They're right down the road, headquartered in Herndon, Virginia. They have over 125,000 learners nationwide. And yet we get incredible personal support from that team. And so I'd like for John Olson to come and share a few words with you.
Just wanted to speak for a couple of minutes. I really appreciate the opportunity to speak on behalf of K-12. As Maddie mentioned, we are serving full-time full-time virtual students, over 125,000 of them right now across the country, and about 10,000 around the world right now in about 80 countries. In addition to that, we'll probably touch another 500,000 kids in about 2,000 school districts across the country today. And we've had a unique position as we become the leader in online learning across the United States to see what districts are doing and to see how much they believe in the future of providing more flexibility and more individualized options for kids. And with that, I've had an opportunity to really see where Alexandria fits in. There are a lot of districts who are trying something. They don't know exactly what they're doing, but they're trying something because it feels commonsensical. You think about how much happens online now in our daily lives, that you should be able to do something with respect to the learning environment that takes advantage of the internet. But the problem is many of these districts today really don't know where they're going. And one of the things I just want you to know from where I sit working with 2,000 school districts is that Alexandria, what differentiates them is that they know where they're going. And I want to congratulate Dr. Sherman for driving that, because that is really, really hard to do. There are a lot of folks, we all grew up going to a regular school. You know, there was one size that fit all of us when we were all growing up. But there's a big difference now, whereas where we all had to wrap our lives around our school experience growing up, kids these days, they want to wrap their school experience around their lives. And when they're demanding that kind of flexibility, you have to come up with better options for them. And it's not just about the curriculum. The curriculum is incredibly important. You have to be world-class in that. But it's about putting the right support mechanisms in place to help every kid succeed based on their individual needs. It's really hard to do at scale. And what is exciting about this for me is, because this is a great example of trying to find that individualized experience for these 98 kids today, and perhaps another 98 tomorrow, it gives me hope that eventually every kid is going to have that pure individualized experience if they need it. Now, let me just take it a different direction here. I'm representing K-12, but I'm also a parent of two kids in the Alexandria City Schools. I have 29-year-old daughters who are as different as you could possibly imagine, and they are both having a wonderful experience. And I really appreciate the fact that everybody in ACPS has always been as caring and as focused on helping those kids succeed based on their individual needs as they possibly can be. And as a result of that, I'm in a position now where I get to give back, and the way I'm going to do that is to make as much out of this partnership as we possibly can. We'll invest $1 million this year in just improving our English courses to make sure they're 100% aligned with Virginia State standards. But that's just the beginning. We'll invest over $20 million per year for the foreseeable future in building new curriculum solutions, which today might look one way, but tomorrow might be adaptive, or might be simulation and gaming. It could be a completely different way. And we're already doing a lot of R&D to make that happen. You folks are going to be on the cutting edge of being able to experience those things and give us feedback on what works and doesn't work. That's the uniqueness of being close by and having us as connected as we are, and I really appreciate that. So thank you very much, Dr. Sherman, and thank you everybody for the opportunity.
Thank you, John. Next we will have now from the team that you really want to hear from, and I'm going to ask our principal, Dr. James Wilson, to come forth. He is no stranger to those of us that are here from Alexandria. He is a veteran educator. He has not only worked across this school division, but also in other divisions in the region as well as across the country. We are ecstatic to have him here leading this satellite campus, and want to welcome and thank him and ask him to share.
Thank you, Madam Chair. The Honorable Mayor, the Honorable Chairperson of the School Board, stakeholders, friends, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, thank you for this particular opportunity. I think I would be remiss within my 2 minutes if I did not say thank you to Dr. Henson for the seamless support that not only has she, but her entire team has given to us. I would also like to say thank you, Dr. Sherman, school board members, and those persons who had enough confidence in taking a chance on James Wilson. It is really, indeed, an honor and a pleasure for me to lead this particular instructional function. I say that because I really don't deserve any of the credit. I know what the research says about the leadership. I know what the research says about the instructional staff, mainly the teachers. I know what the research says about building relationships. But I'm saying to each and every one of you, the credit goes to the students here, the parents, and the staff. And I want my staff to come forward. If you come here at 8 o'clock in the morning, you will see staff members here. If you come at 8 o'clock at night, you will see staff. If you come in on Saturday mornings, you will see staff, and may I add, and students. May I say to you, thank you very much. Thank you for all that you've done for the youngsters, for the students, and thank you for supporting Alexander City Public Schools. Congratulations to you as well. Thank you very much. Also, if I would like to go home today and enjoy my night there, I possibly should introduce my wife, who is here, Stephanie Wilson. Thank you for your support. She knows the hours, she understands that, and I saw two of my children here. Where's Alan? Alan, just give us a wave. Thank you very much, and Alicia, I saw you as well. Thank you very much. I see John Porter there. Is that John Porter? John, you look young and younger. Thank you. Welcome to all of you. Let me share this with you. The vision is clear. We're here to support the Alexander City Public Schools vision. Yes, we have a non-traditional program. Yes, we work in conjunction with T.C. Williams and the middle schools and Alexander City Public Schools. But I am saying to you, the satellite concept is ingenious. Our students, already we have had one who has completed the work. Some of the students are coming at 8 in the morning and staying all the way 8 at night. We have had one student who has completed. As soon as this is over, and I promise them that I will not be very long, as soon as this is over, we have one who has taken a final exam and she wanted to wait. We encourage her to wait until we finish because we want her to do her best. But may I say again, thank you very much, Dr. Henson again. Thank you so much for all that you've done to your entire department and also to the Alexander City Public Schools. Thank you for everything.
My name is Andrew Langford, and it is a privilege to be standing here in front of you today, speaking on behalf of the students of Satellite. At first, I was a little skeptical about coming to Satellite because I heard a lot of things I didn't agree with. For example, I heard that I would have to be here doing everything by myself because there's no teacher sitting right here in front of me. But from day one, if I had any questions, there was always someone there to answer. Satellite is a big help in managing time, which helps in the real world. Satellite is a dream come true, and I would like to thank everyone that helped make this dream come true. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. And we also have some words from Christopher Whitehead, also in the class of 2013.
How's everybody doing? I'm a senior here at the Satellite campus. I was probably one of the first to jump on the ship. I looked at it as a window of opportunity. I can finish my classes, on my own. I like the setting. Everything's great here. The teachers are great. The staff is great. And I'd like to thank everybody who helped put this together. Thank you.
Wanted to speak. I don't know if he made it. Is up here? Yeah, great. We have Mr. D who's with us.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Well, one thing for sure, the city is doing phenomenal. And I'm a proud parent to say, you know, I'm so happy with what the city is doing because, I mean, myself personally, and it's not about me, it's about us. I didn't get a diploma. But today I stand before you, a proud parent of four and two in TC, well, one in TC Williams and one in Hammond right now. And I know that they're going to aspire to be great gentlemen amongst this great city. And I'm just, you know, here to share a few encouraging words. I will begin by saying, being witness to the creation of Marvel Massive Magnitude has always guided and corrected our choices, positioning us in life at this very moment to receive our rise from the lows of ourselves. We react in poverty. Imagine the reaction from our risen thoughts, producing and raising rural reproduction. If there has ever been a time, it's now. We must not fall victim to ignorance. We must be useful and operational in order for an existing environment to remain a success. We are held accountable for the illiteracy nations feed throughout the world. Without discipline and the word, that will save life instead of taking the war. Thank you.
All who had a word this morning, and now what we'd love for you to have the opportunity to do, we're going to cut the ribbon and we're going to invite you to visit the Zuni.
Alexandria Public School System has found many different ways to provide education to our students because there are many challenges and needs in the lives of students. And as you heard from one of the speakers, the way you teach and the way you educate today is different from when we came up 20, 30, 40 years ago. And so we need to be part of that 21st century education process. And I think this campus speaks to that because it affords students who need to work and need to do some other things, but to also continue their education so that they can get their diploma and graduate.
It's actually our first school that we've gone through from beginning of vision until the completion of implementation, and I'm just very proud to have been part of this. It really fulfills our mission and vision to help every student achieve their potential. And I know that we're going to do everything we need to do in order to ensure every student's success. And my input from the students so far is just amazingly positive. It's exceeding their expectations, and I know they're going to exceed our expectations.
Yesterday I met with a student when I was here at the Satellite Campus, and she was telling me her story, and she had attended TC in the past. She had dropped out for a year and then moved away, and now she's back into the city. And so when she heard about the Satellite Campus and that it was a non-traditional environment and that she could come here on her own time because she also works, that was a big attraction to her. She was kind of embarrassed to go to TC because she knew a lot of the students there, and the students knew that she had dropped out and that she had come back to the city. And so she was very excited that Alexandria now has a program for her where she can re-enroll in school, realize her dreams for herself, graduate with a high school diploma, and doing it in a non-traditional way so that she can be here in the evenings on the weekends and be able to work full-time in order to do that.
This little girl Friday said, "I get to be in charge of my own learning." I've never been in charge of my own learning. Another little girl is finishing her first course a day and taking the final exam as soon as this party's over with. Only been in school 18 days and she's knocked out her first course. It's awesome.
To be very candid, my expectations were extremely high, but this particular program has actually exceeded my expectations. The youngsters are serious about their academics. They are excited about the flexibility that they have.
Be honest with you, I had no idea. And it was kind of hard letting go of your normal classroom routine. It's you come in every day and you're kind of in charge of your room. And here now we're kind of sharing space and And it's just different. It's not traditional, and you just had to kind of let go of your normal teacher expectations and just kind of embrace it.
I've taught for 15 years in a regular classroom situation, and what I'm able to do here for these students, I was doing before and after school on my own time because this is what's needed. Actually flipping the classroom and being there for every aspect, whether it's their classwork or their homework, we're there for them. And they're able to work at their own pace, and it just enables them to take responsibility and take ownership of their education. So it's educating them in every aspect.
I'm very excited that we have this satellite opportunity for our children here in Alexandria. It provides our children a more individualized education for those students that particularly need that. We have for several years prided ourselves in developing individual achievement plans for all of our students. But this gives us one more avenue of really making them individualized.
My daughter Stephanie was interested in coming to the satellite campus because she told me that she felt kind of lost in the number of students that they have at TC, and I've found so far that she's had a really great experience at the satellite school, a lot of individual attention and focus by the teachers and the counselors.
My name is Anthony Fullen, and I'm going to read what I think about the TC Satellite Campus. The poem that I'm going to read to you is called Sleeping in the Clouds. Prayers goes up, blessing comes down. Dreams keep our spirits up, nightmares keep it down. We are all the same because we are human. We got the same picture frames, but we all strike different picture poses. We are the satellite campus living in a high-tech timeline. Our stories are always have different lifetimes. Some stories are breathtaking, other stories are life-breaking. These are the times that matter the most, but we fear getting close. This is our time to show no matter who you are or what you have done, you can do it. Let's show that the underdogs can win. After you have done your best, you can finally rest and your pillow will feel like you're sleeping in the clouds.